Hello everyone, today I want to make this video to share with you the reinforcement issues and to talk about how to reinforce an existing building, because nowadays many building owners or many societies want to add, for example, new floors or bring new loads on the structure. So we need to see our structure if it can support these new loads or not. For example, here we have profiling, and we need, for example, for this example, we are going to reinforce it with two pipes, and it's a model that it's a design we very use nowadays, and it's easy to realize. So in general, we go to profiling and we can select new one, and we can choose reconstructed, variable, composite, special, etc., and we have lots and lots of proposed designs. We just fill in the blanks and make the dimensions, and we can create wherever we want, but it's limited here. For our example, can't utilize this method, so we are going to file and we select new project, and we click here studying section. So here we are going to bring our profile, so we are going to click file, import from catalogue, and we can choose our profile IPE 270. And there it is. So for the reinforcement, can use also very different sections, like we are going to bring it, for example, we are going to choose UB and it's 240, and we select it. We can here rotate it, or we can translate it, and wherever we want, you click from the beginning, you choose the end, wherever you want, or you make distance or the coordinates. We can also select it, use a mirror, a vertical or horizontal mirror, and click copy to copy it there. You have the possibility to create whatever you want. So for our example, we are going to create a section which is a circle. We are going to put our dimensions. So for my project, I am going to need the dimensions that I work with, and there it is, and I can copy from the other side. But for our example here, it is like it have a hole there, so we are going to create another circle. It's the same center, but you are going to see that it's gonna be created as a hole. So we are going to put 3.8, and there it is. On the other side also, like this. You can select here, you can right click characteristics, and it's clear that it's considered as a hole, not a full material steel. So here we can pass to analyze the section, you find all the characteristics. In fact, I'm sorry, you can make results. So here he can calculate our new section that we have created. You have all the characteristics. So now we can see all the different characteristics that you want to see. You can navigate and see what it's going to show you. You can have the document also that generates with the stress analysis, not only this, the full document of the section, the characteristics of the sections are quickly calculated. So now, as we finish it, we are going to save this in the catalog, and it's gonna be in the user, and we are going to name it like I don't know, give it a name. And for the dimensions, we are going to make it like to make only one, so it keeps the dimensions as we created it in centimeters. The unit is centimeter, so it's gonna be saved. So now we are going to be back to our project. Yes, please. And then we are going to click on profiling, add a new one, and we are going to select the user. So in the user, we are going to find what we've created. You can change the name, you can make whatever you want, and click to add. It's here, and then you can select, for example, the bar 17, and click applicate, or maybe you can maybe select like this here. You see section, and you find all the sections you have created, the same list. You can directly select it, and then you can go to dimensions, and you can calculate and verify if your structure is capable to support the new loads that you have made. And that's it. We are here for the end of the video. I'm thanking you for watching until the end, and I'll put my contact in the description, so you can contact me as soon as I'm available. I will respond for comments, your messages, and thank you for watching again, and see you next time.